Hi, I'm Steve Sullivan, Training Supervisor at Rittal North America. Are you frustrated with the limitations of using unibody enclosures? If so, Rittal has a solution for you, the SE8 system enclosure. In this video, we're going to compare the SE8 with a very commonly used enclosure in the industry, the freestanding unibody.
The design of the SE8 enclosure is perfect for those who are tired of the limitations and high use costs of working with unibody enclosures, but they don't quite feel ready to make the jump to a fully modular frame-based system. So let's start with the door benefits of the SE8 door system. The SE8 has four hinges and four latching points. It's easily removable, easily reversible, and it also has a mounting frame on the door to mount accessories. Very simple to remove this door. I use a flat blade screwdriver and I simply lift out the two hinge pins which are captive to the hinge body. When I look at the unibody design, it also has four hinges but only three catch points. It's not reversible and it has no mounting frame for accessories. After I remove the door, to do this task I use a pair of pliers and a mallet simply to tap out the long hinge pin for each hinge body. The mounting panel in each enclosure is the most important surface on which we mount our controls. This is standard with the SE8. This part is part of just the one part number that's required to order an SE8 enclosure. That gets you the enclosure, panel included, and installed as you see here. To remove the panel, I only loosened two screws. Then to slide the panel back in, I only put two screws back in. This is very simple. When I start with the unibody design, the panel is an additional part number, an additional cost, and in the hardware bag for that mounting panel in the unibody enclosure is 42 pieces of hardware. An assortment of spring nuts, washers, brackets, bolts and nuts. Once you have those installed on the strut within the enclosure, then you hang the panel on the hardware. This does not install consistently. You have to mark the strut and measure where you want to install this panel. To remove the panel, then I also have to remove six additional pieces of hardware to take my panel out from a, let's say, floating position. It is not conveniently able to slide out or lift out as the Rittal panel does. Without having a panel assist, this lifting off of the hardware, it's no wonder why most people using this type of enclosure system choose to lay the enclosure on its back and then hoist the mounting panel out of the enclosure and then the reverse to install it. Cable entry systems with the SE8, very simple, very straightforward. If I choose to remove the slide rails from the mounting panel, this further opens up my cable entry system and I can simply slide across the cable entry plates to bring in my cables and wires. In the unibody, I'm drilling holes. This is hard on you, it's hard on your tools, and it's hard on your budget. Surface finish on Rittal includes nano coating, primer paint, and textured powder. The unibody smooth surface easily shows unappealing weld marks and grind marks through its coat of paint. The gasketing used in the Rittal SE8 enclosure is a robotically applied, foamed in place gasket with no seams. The other guys use strip gasket, which has seams. Interior installation is really the highlight and the benefit of the SE8 versus a unibody. Very simple, very quick to add hundreds of accessories inside of the SE8 enclosure where you can't do that with the unibody. Unibody is limited to what you can do with strut and a bunch of hardware. Very time consuming, very difficult to do the installation. Door locking and latching with the SE8 is with a continuous lock bar utilizing the double bit key and the double bit insert. On the unibody, you have a three-point latching system with a tongue that grinds the paint on the inside of the body, damaging that paint at every occurrence. With the SE8, if I choose to put an accessory handle, let's say for example, a comfort handle, either with or without a provision for a padlock, or without a different type of locking insert in this handle with a set of keys. Very simple to do. I simply remove two screws on the inside of the door, place my handle, two screws back on, and now I have a very nice functional lockout system for my enclosure. The rear wall on the SE8 is removable. This allows us to do a couple configurations. One, I can remove the rear wall and add a rear door. So now I have dual access front and rear. Possibly I want to take that a step further and put two mounting panels inside of the SE8 and then door on the front, door on the back. If I don't want to do that and keep it simple, I can remove my rear wall, and this helps me have unimpeded access inside of the enclosure as I do my installation of wires and cables and other control and switchgear components going in. The SE8 on the chassis is one piece of steel along the roof and the sidewalls, fully nano-coated, powder-coated primer inside and out. Folks, the time is right, the price is right to try the SE8 system enclosure from Rittal.